But let's start today with considering order of convergence examples, like you had in your homework. And in fact, I'll modify it. Say we're talking about this particular sequence, 1 over n to the k, where k is any positive number. And you might wonder, does the sequence defined by this formula here converge? Well, first of all, does it converge at all? Secondly, if it converges, what does it converge to? Thirdly, does it converge linearly? Does it converge quadratically? What kind of convergence is it? I hope it's pretty clear this converges, and I hope it's clear what it converges to. Can you just tell me by looking at it? Zero, yeah, Pn. Clearly, with k being positive here, Pn goes to zero as n goes to infinity. Is that hard, easy to prove? Would you have to prove it? I would not require you to prove it on the test. If you were trying to think about proving it, you'd want to think about the absolute value of Pn minus zero and show that goes to zero as n goes to infinity. Well, subtract zero, you just get Pn. K here again, by the way, is fixed, a fixed positive number. These things are positive, so you can get rid of the absolute value signs. If you were going to prove more rigorously that this goes to zero, you'd want to choose n large enough to make this less than an arbitrarily given epsilon. You'd want to choose n large enough to make that true. And the question is, how large would n need to be to make that true? I'm really just doing scratch work here. I'm not really doing a proof. You'd want to essentially solve this inequality for n. You could take the reciprocals of both sides. That does change the direction of the inequality. And then you could take the kth root of both sides. And you could say you want to choose n to be bigger than the kth root of the square root of 1 over epsilon. Now, if epsilon is a really tiny number, 10 to the negative 100 or something, really, really tiny, 1 over that's going to be really big, 10 to the positive 100. The kth root, well, that could be small or relatively large depending on how big k is. K is small, like 2 or something. It's still a relatively large number here. This essentially is telling you how big to choose the n to make this true. And so you'd have to work backwards to ultimately prove that when n is this big or larger, that this is true. And that would be the essence of the proof. I'm just mentioning that. I'm not going to require you to do this kind of proof. This is a real analysis kind of proof in this class. But just to mention, that is what would go into proving that this goes to zero as n goes to infinity. Does it converge to zero linearly? We'd have to go back to the definition of linear convergence. You'd need to compute the limit as n goes to infinity. Remember what it was? The absolute value of Pn plus 1 minus p over the absolute value of Pn minus p to the alpha power, where alpha is 1 for linear convergence. And you're wondering, does this equal some positive constant? Alpha equals 1 for linear convergence. Alpha equals 2 for quadratic convergence. Let's go ahead and assume alpha is 1 here. And go ahead and compute this limit. P is going to be 0 for our example. Both of those are going to be 0 for our example. And the absolute values are not going to matter. P sub n plus 1 is the same as this formula with n replaced by n plus 1. You're dividing by P sub n effectively. So you got to multiply it by its reciprocal. You really get n to the k over n plus 1 to the k. That can be written as one fraction, or you can think of it as a rational function of n. Either way you think of it, you can think of it like this if you want. This thing inside the parentheses goes to 1 as n goes to infinity. K is a positive number. Something going to 1 raised to a constant power is still going to go to 1. This limit is going to be 1. You also could think of it as a, if k is an integer, at least a rational function of n here, where the degree of the top and the bottom are the same. And so you'd look at the coefficients of those highest powers. Point is, the limit is 1. one is a positive number. This is converging linearly to zero. Okay. Again, this is a positive number, not infinity. This is enough to confirm linear convergence. Does it converge? Could it also converge quadratically? Is it possible to converge both linearly and quadratically? The answer is no. If you computed the limit as n goes to infinity of pn plus 1 minus p over pn plus 1 minus a pn minus p in absolute value squared, alpha equals 2 for quadratic convergence, what would you get? This would be the limit as n goes to infinity of, yeah, p sub n plus 1 over, ultimately, again, p is 0 here, you'd get p sub n quantity squared. That would be the limit as n goes to infinity. If you are careful about things again here, you're going to get n to the 2k up top here because of the square down there, and n plus 1 to the k. And that's definitely something, that's a k there, by the way, if you can't quite tell. That's definitely something that diverges. It goes to infinity. If you think of it as a rational function of n, if you pretend k is an integer, positive integer here, the degree of the top is twice as high as the degree of the bottom. It's a rational function of n that's definitely going to go to infinity. I also could think of it as n squared over n plus 1 to the k. That thing inside the parentheses goes to infinity as n goes to infinity, even if k was not a positive whole number. This is going to go to infinity, not a positive real number here. It does not converge quadratically. You and your homework had an example of a sequence that did converge quadratically. It was this one, 10 to the negative 2 to the n. Hopefully you found the proof of that not too hard. Essentially, you do this kind of calculation and see that you get a positive real number when you compute that thing. This certainly, if you think about the sequence itself, does converge to zero very rapidly. P sub zero is 10 to the negative 2 to the 0, which is 10 to the negative 1. P sub 1 is, turns out, 10 to the negative 2. P sub 2 is 10 to the negative 4. P sub 3 is 10 to the negative 8. P sub 4 is 10 to the negative 16. It is converging to zero much more rapidly than we're used to seeing here. And it turns out it's converging to zero quadratically. If you were going to write these out as decimals, you know, 10 to the negative 32 is 0.000 with 31 zeros and then a 1. It's converging to zero very rapidly, more rapidly than we're used to with most sequences. Okay. So that's an example that you did have for the homework and could come up on the test too. So be able to think about linear and quadratic convergence with simple examples.